in Kumamoto, just outside at one of the shelters. They got 77 of these things that people are staying in, put up, I don't know what you'd call them, little box style houses. And we just went to the supermarket and got a whole bunch of stuff, just stuff that they need, you know, toilet paper and other household needs and stuff that they don't get, because to this place they haven't had any media coverage or any help. But there's been a lot of stuff I just heard from my guy about how the people have been ripped off and abused and no support and, you know, fucking corruption, all sorts of things. This is really horrible. So anyway, instead of you know, talking about charity and all this sort of thing and pray for Kumamoto, I want to come and do something about it. So anyway, here's the manager. Yeah, that's Sumi, my representative in Kumamoto, and he's just taking me out to a place called Mashiki, which is one of the most affected, I probably can't see it from behind me here, but one of the most affected places in Kumamoto, and just trying to create some sort of pipeline of support as best we can, because the place that they usually go shopping is gone. We just went through a couple of streets and just saw that it's still the same situation. They've cleared up the road, as you can see, we're driving on the road normally now, but all around us is just houses that are absolutely fucked. So anyway, have a look at the next couple of videos I'm going to put together on the end of this, and you'll see where we've been driving around. Yes, we are speaking Japanese the whole time, but you'll pretty much get the gist of it, I'm sure. And yeah, it's pretty hard to look at. A lot of people have just lost their houses and everything. You know, the place we just went to, they had 77 little box style houses that people are living in, and people here, as he's just explained to me, are used to having their own massive house with their own massive yard, and a lot of them have little, you know, farm bits of land going on and stuff, and now they're in these boxes with, you know, nearly 80 other little families, and they're all clashing heads, you know, as you would. They're all getting up in each other's space. We had one kid start on us while we were bringing some shit. He was like early 20s or something, and he was having a go at the old lady, and we were in there like dropping off some of the gear, and he was having a go about, you know, our cars being parked in the way of where he wanted to go or whatever, which he still could have gone through, but just starting trouble. Anyway, I look out and we were both thinking, fuck this guy, but then at the same time, you got to think, you know, what are these guys going through? Like, you know, to live there and to be in that situation and just putting up with this shit, you know, their situation all day, every day, and in each other's faces, they get annoyed pretty quickly, and you got to try and, you know, try and see it from their point of view. So that's, you know, luckily nothing came of that, and then we all talked and it was all fine and everyone appreciates what's going on, and it was a good outcome. But just to see that, you know, how stressed that they can get, yeah, it's it really does give you a bit of an insight as to the situation, because a lot of people just, you know, their whole world's just crumbled, as you'll see. Everything, not everything, but a lot of places just dropped, you know. And a lot of shops around here, even in this main part, that still you still can't go into. Like we were saying before, one of the shopping centers, it's fucked. You can't go in there, and so people can't go get their goods. They have to come right here into town, and you know, some of the roads are still pretty fucked and everything. It's been 6 months, but the even more scarier thing than that, and the thing that really grips my shit, is that, you know, they're talking about, oh yeah, pray for Kumamoto, pray for Kumamoto and all this. And I've seen a lot of people do charity events for Kumamoto, and it's really fucked me off, you know. It's really, really fucked me off. That's what I said to him. It came out that I was coming to Kumamoto, and then I had said to staff that I wanted to see Kumamoto, the situation, and help as I could. And then they said to him that I was going to come and see the class, which means, you know, get everyone together. I didn't mean that. So there's kind of a miscommunication there. You know, it turned out that we put on a seminar, and that money from that is going to go to the next month's, you know, what these people need and everything. But I didn't actually want to do it too openly. I just wanted to go there, give what we can. You know, I took the profits from the seminar last weekend in Osaka, and I'll use that, and we'll keep using more and more for, you know, whatever they need. So that's the plan. But I didn't want to go and advertise it like that. I just wanted to do it. It was my own thing, and I was very open about that on, you know, Facebook and YouTube and everything. I was like, fuck all these guys, you know, who are actually making money off their so-called charities, which is, believe it or not, a lot of corruption going on, a lot of bureaucracy going on, a lot of absolute fuckery going on, to be honest with you. And the people who are affected by it, you just, you know, you got to try and look at it through their eyes when you're dealing with them, because I'm surprised they haven't lost their shit entirely, you know, put it that way. So it really does, you come here and you see it yourself. I was finally able to get here myself. I tried to rearrange my schedule, but I was between America and UK and, you know, many other places here. I'm finally able to get here and just did what I could. I know a lot of other people are doing more, and that's awesome. But if you are able to do something, then you do. Then that's a positive mindset that I'm hoping to maybe lead by example with, or try and share. Because if you know a few more people do that, then you know really can start to make a difference. I guess, if that doesn't sound too corny, but anyway. Yeah, we're just coming back through the city, which we saw before, this little arcade bit. It's not that little, just dropped, and there was, yeah, it's fucked. As you can see just there, the building, they're all in reconstruction. Some over here, I can't even go into anymore. It's crazy, you know? So, yeah, there's a lot of talk as to, let's fix it, let's do this for Kumamoto, and there's, you know, you come here 6 months later, it's nearly six more. 半年ぐらいもう経ってるよね?
半年、あとちょっとで、今月の半ばで半年です。About two weeks,
in about 2 weeks time it'll be half a year. So, you know, a lot of talk, a lot less action. And apparently the place we just went to, it took them like a month or 2 months, I think, to make that shit happen.
What?
Bus. Oh, fuck. Yeah, the bus is like on its side. It's like... fuck, because the road's fucked. One part we just went through before was like being in Australian outback, you know, fucking. It's crazy. See all these buildings getting rebuilt and stuff, or fixed, and some are just condemned. It's just mind blowing, absolutely mind blowing. So, anyway, I can't really say much on file like this, on record, about whatever, about the corruption and everything, but it's just so fucking typical and it's so disappointing. A lot of money, a lot of volunteers that have come in have actually. You know, a lot of people have been taking the money, a lot of volunteers have actually been stealing shit, and it's just kind of stuff that you just wouldn't believe until you actually see it. So I'm very grateful that I'm was able to come here and do something, and again, the main reason I'm just sharing this video is just to spread awareness, and maybe hopefully you guys can, maybe some of you might want to do something to help as well. Thank you to those of you who did send money. We had guys from Ireland and from other branches, and guys from other branches that came here and helped out and everything. That's much appreciated. Hopefully from now on too, we can keep that pipeline going and that support. So thanks for watching, and cheer if you want. Cheers.
もちろんこの辺は住んでないんで、はい、はい、住めないです。え、住めないです。で、要は死なんかったねっていう話。確かその辺だったんですよね。あの子供が救出されたの、確かそっちの家だったかな。確かその辺だったと思いますけど。で、あの今通路沿いをほとんど見てもらった状態ですけど、中入ると、こんな状態なんですね。悲惨ですね。
We're in Kumamoto Castle right now. And it's all kind of fucked up over there, but it's very nice here. It's a very beautiful place, smells very good. And we're now looking for some food. We've got Chinese food in here. It's strange, but anyway, now we're looking for some meat. Niku kuite na. So you kidding? Nah.
I did.
There she goes.